it's just a random Tuesday, but do you need reason to celebrate? Of course you do. So we're going to give you a reason. Today is National Strawberry Shortcake Day.
That's right.
So we invited our good friend Stefanie Paganini here from the Paganini School of Cooking to show us how to make this summertime favorite. There's nothing better than strawberry shortcake
has been around since the early 1800s, and it is something that I think everyone has in their pantry. And when strawberries are so big and beautiful, like these beautiful ones that we got from Driscoll today, it's really the time to make it. So what people don't know is that a lot of people make strawberry shortcake maybe with angel food cake or with sponge cake.
Right.
But the traditional old-fashioned strawberry shortcake is with a shortcake, which is actually a sweetened biscuit. So I'm going to have you go ahead and make it. I brought gloves.
Right. Okay.
Have time. And what we're going to do is we're going to put into your bowl about 2.5 cups of flour.
All right.
We're going to put in about 1/2 cup of...
Let me ask you, do you use the whole wheat flour? Some of the, we're seeing that out in
the
stores
now. Yeah, you can. Do you use that? You absolutely can.
I'm starting to mix a little bit. Is that okay?
You have to watch for is that the whole flour, the whole wheat, when they use, they're getting not only the endosperm, which is the part you want, but they're getting the bran, which is that harder part on the outside. Mm-hmm. It's going to affect the density of whatever you're making. It's going to make it heavier.
Okay.
And it's going to make your structure inside a little coarser. Something like a shortcake is ideal if you want to split it 1/2 and 1/2.
Okay, great. All right.
So in here, I'm putting some cold butter that we've cut up, and you're just going to mix it together to make it look like coarse cornmeal. So get that butter all coated with the flour.
All right.
To that, I'm going to add some baking powder, some baking soda, cinnamon, and salt.
Nice.
And then while you're doing that,
what
we're going to add to it is actually buttermilk. So we've added baking soda and baking powder. Both react to an acid. So we're going to add buttermilk, which is milk that has a little bit of a curdle to it or an acidity to it.
All right.
And if you don't have it at home, you most certainly can make your own. For every cup of milk, you want to put about 1 tablespoon of lemon juice or white vinegar.
And then just let it sit for a couple
minutes and it'll curdle on its own. So right next to you, you have the cow full of buttermilk. If you want to go ahead and pour him in.
Okay, he's very cute. I don't know if we have any sound effects or not, but darling. Okay, my grandmother has one of these at home, too.
Good. And you can dump them out, too, if you want.
But I just thought it was cute.
You know, good, fun, summer fun.
Darling, kids love this.
And then just a splash of the vanilla extract that you have in front of you.
You got it. I love how you go splash. That's how I cook, too.
Should
I keep mixing here?
Yeah, keep mixing.
Okay.
So your batter is actually going to turn into a dough that you're going to put in an 8-inch cake pan that you've buttered and floured. And then after you've baked it for about 25 to 30 minutes, this is what it's going to end up looking like. Mm. So what you have all gooey in your hands, it's going to turn into this beautiful thing right here, which is just a monster biscuit.
How long do you bake it?
About 25 to 30 minutes. Okay. It's going to go in a very hot oven at 425 degrees.
25, okay.
Because we want to get that real beautiful initial spring on our biscuit. And again, we want it to have this nice crusty outside. So we're going to cut it open just in half. And so we have a beautiful top part, and then we have our bottom half. And we're going to build our strawberry shortcake this way. So you want to take whole whipping cream, whip it with a little bit of powdered sugar, and then we added a little bit of orange zest to it.
Nice.
So it's got a little bit of an orange flavor.
The smell is fantastic, too. It smells so springy. And
then you're going to really fill this whole thing up. So I'm going to, for the interest of time, pretend that we got this whole thing full of it.
Sounds good. We do have about 30 seconds stuff.
You're going to put your strawberries in it. Just fill the whole inside with strawberries. And then once you get it all filled, you've got strawberries. You've mixed them maybe with a little bit of sugar. You're going to top it. And then on top, you're going to put little dollops using that same whipped cream.
Like what you did over there.
With just some strawberries, and you can finish it off with just some really pretty strawberries.
Just stunning. And I imagine if you want to share the love, you can add some blueberries or
raspberries. I mean, as the season goes on, you can continue to make your shortcake. Just switch out whichever fruit is currently in season.
Mm, this looks fantastic. So we have the recipe for this, for Steph's strawberry shortcake. You can find it on fox8.com. Be sure you click on AM Show. Looks like too pretty to eat.
Oh, no, it's edible.
We'll dig into it. It's always so good to see you.
Same
and your stuff. Mom's getting back from Italy tonight.
Yeah. She's back tonight. She's been 3 weeks doing gastronomic tours of Italy, so I'm very happy to have her home.
I bet.
And take some time off.
Oh, gosh. God bless. I'm sure, because then that means you're running the school, right?
Right.
Right. All right. Tell your
mom
we said hi.
Thanks. We'll do.
All right. It is now almost 8:30, 27 minutes after the hour. Summer almost here. Now that we're doing strawberries, I think we could kind of say it's arrived.